Good morning, TC. I'm Lindsay Hoover.
And I'm Brenna Flanagan.
And this is the GF Current. Another episode of The Current and our last official show of the school year.
That's right, Lindsay. In this episode, we'll be highlighting the Pett Memorial Library, spring weather, and TC's very own boxer, Melvis Madrigan.
Before we go to our reporters, we have a few brief news updates.
Recently at TC, junior Drew Barker broke two track records. On the 55-meter hurdle, he ran at 7.6 seconds, and on the 110-meter, he ran at 14.6 seconds. Tomorrow's edition of the Golden Fleece will be featuring a story on Barker and a former Rams quarterback who recently signed with UAB.
As most of you probably have heard, on Monday a tragedy took place in Boston during the Boston Marathon, where bombs were set off. At this time, although fatalities have been low, the number of people hurt has risen to over 140. At TC, we join with others around the nation in support of Boston and those affected by this event.
Recently, students around the school have been participating in the building of our school's playhouse that will be featured in a competition on Sunday. Here's reporter Lily Anderson on more about what it took to build the house.
The newly completed playhouse has been a labor of love, according to the teachers and many students who have contributed to its planning, designing, and building since the 1st of January. Members of four classes, Marketing, Drafting, Interior Design, and Horticulture 2, have been working to get the playhouse ready, just in time for the building competition this Sunday at 3. The playhouse competition is part of the Home Builders Show at the Western North Carolina Agricultural Center, which will feature six playhouses constructed by each of the public high schools in the county. This is the first year that the schools have been required by the county to compete in the competition, which has been especially hard for Robertson.
We're kind of at a disadvantage because we don't have a construction class. These guys have done a really good job putting this together.
The green and white playhouse itself is 6 feet by 8 feet and about 5 feet tall. It has two windows and a real architectural shingled roof. The supplies for the playhouse were donated by the home building company Deltek, which is part of the competition rules. The playhouse's worth has been estimated at between $1,500 and $2,500. All 100 raffle tickets have been sold. The tickets will also serve as free admission to the Builder's Show and Playhouse Competition.
I think it'll do really good. We worked really hard and took our time with it, so it should be really nice. I think it's going to do awesome.
As some of you may know, our school has our very own Pep Library in memorial of one of our former students here at TC.
Hey guys, I'm Ali Anderson, bringing you the story of the Merrill Snyder Memorial Library.
Merrill loved she loved the interaction, even though she never spoke. She loved the interaction of sitting down with somebody and reading a book or listening to music or watching a video, and it seemed very age appropriate, and I think that that's why a library was started. After Merrill passed away, people were coming to us and asking what they could do to help, and so we went into the school and we discovered that they were just in need of everything. There were so many budget cuts and they hadn't lost teacher's assistants, but they didn't have enough supplies in the room. They didn't have, you know, pencils and coloring paper and books and games. And so we just asked people to donate something. And that Christmas, we had 9 tables full of everything. I mean, books, puzzles, games, you name it. It was just overwhelming how much stuff we had. So then we just didn't want it as a free-for-all. We wanted the students to be able to use it continuously. And we cleaned out what was an old art room and storage room, and that's how the library came to be. I think the most special thing for us would be that if you look around your house, you probably have something that you're not using anymore. And if you donate it, then somebody else, I mean, it would bring such joy to someone else. So if you've got an old book or a movie or a game or a puzzle or, you know, anything like that, just think about donating it and sort of recycling it, because I know that they would be real appreciative.
Merrill's life will always be remembered by the children who use the library every day. With the GF Current, I'm Lily Anderson.
It's always great to find out about the people who are honored at our school. Around this time every year, the weather begins to get warmer, the flowers begin to grow, and for thousands of people, eyes begin to itch. That's right, it's spring once again in Asheville.
Just like the ducks and geese of Lake Julian Park, spring is returning here to Asheville, bringing warmer weather and colorful flowers. Annual springtime holidays are back as well. Easter and St. Patrick's Day just recently passed, so the feeling of spring is officially in the air.
I'm really excited about spring because I'm tired of this cold, nasty weather. I mean, if it's going to snow during winter, then it should snow, not be gross and rainy and cold.
Here in Asheville, enjoying the outdoors is a common activity for tourists and locals. Spring is bringing beautiful weather and encouraging people to go outside.
As great as spring is, it just makes all of us want summer break that much more. Only 33 more days left, Lindsay.
I can't wait. Before we go to Lily for sports, here's Brianna and Scott with the latest music and apps that will help you get through these last few weeks of school.
Hey TC, I'm Brianna Ullman and this is the Music Minute. In this episode, I'll be reviewing the newest albums from Kid Cudi, Luke Bryan, and Phoenix. Thankfully, Kid Cudi has returned to rap with the release of his newest album, Indie Cut, coming out this Tuesday. Kid Cudi delivers amazing songs as always. Indie Cut, however, is different than his older music due to its more upbeat and positive tone. I expect the album's single, Just What I Am, to become a huge hit. The relaxing, cool beats and electronic influences guarantee the song's success. I also love that Kid Cudi has stayed consistent with his trademark catchy but laid-back style. If you're looking for more of his music, I highly recommend listening to the newly released single Immortal or downloading the entire album.
You're like a screen flashing, insufficient funds, cops knocking when the party's just begun. You're a big rain cloud parked over my boat.
This year, Luke Bryan continues his tradition of releasing an annual springtime album. His fourth record, called Spring Break, Here to Party, is packed with the catchy, upbeat country songs that Bryan is known and loved for. Although this is a compilation album with mostly older tracks, two new songs were recorded. My favorite is Buzzkill, a sad song disguised by an upbeat melody that truly defines country music. I definitely recommend that any country fans listen to this album immediately. Headline from this day. Any indie rock fan should check out Phoenix's new album, Bankrupt, as soon as possible. The band, who recently performed at the Coachella Music Festival and Saturday Night Live, is known for their singles such as Liztomania and 1901. In their new album, which comes out Tuesday, the band continues to release catchy pop songs with an electronic twist. My favorite is their newest single, Entertainment, because of its irresistible dance beat. I highly recommend downloading the song and album. Other recently released albums are 2020 by Justin Timberlake, Paramore's self-titled release, Hotel California by Tyga, and Wolf by Tyler, the Creator. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out the brand new episode of Fast Tracks, the Golden Fleece Online's music review. For the GF Current, I'm Brianna Ullman.
Do you know what time it is? I think it's time for some more app reviews. I mean, what else did you expect from App Central? I just want to take a minute here and marvel at the leaps in advancement technology has taken over the past few years. Why, now our mobile phones are so advanced they can practically run themselves. Automate It is a very useful tool I stumbled upon in the Google Play Store. Basically, you can use this app to set certain actions to run in response to certain triggers. The actions and triggers can be practically anything that your phone does, and you can even set multiple action and trigger conditions. In other words, you could do something like, when Wi-Fi is connected and the power is plugged in, set the screen brightness to 100%. If you've ever been fascinated by light spectrums or lasers, then this puzzle game that I downloaded several years ago may be just the thing for you. Lumen is a reflection-based laser puzzle game. The object of the game is to place a laser and light up all of the checkpoints with the correct color. The trick is redirecting the laser in the correct places and alternating the colors in the right order. The best part about the puzzles is that there isn't one single way to solve each one, and you can even make your own and upload them online for other people to play. Another game that I've discovered in my travels is a game that should only be attempted by the geometrically seasoned. Super Hexagon is a game only attempted by the bravest of souls. This game gives you hours of fun proportional to its difficulty level. The object of the game is to avoid running into the walls of closing hexagons with this little white ball thing that you control. You win the game by surviving for 60 seconds. Sounds easy, but with difficulty levels that start on hard and only get harder, you may find this to be quite the rigorous feat. Well, I'm done here for this episode. If you have any ideas for future apps that I should review, go ahead and get them on into me before I go away forever, for the next episode is the last one. And so, for the GF Current, I'm Scott Schrein.
Hey guys, I'm Lily Anderson, and welcome to sports. Last weekend, the boys and girls track team participated in the Taco Bell Classic meet.
And the base keeps running, running, and 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 running, running.
For the Robertson track team, it's more than just jumping the farthest or running the fastest. It's about being a team and encouraging each other to do their best, according to freshman Bailey Woodson.
The events really don't matter, and I think because there are so many people on the team, we have an opportunity to bond closer to each other because we're always there cheering on everybody else and watching everybody's event. So.
We cheer each other on.
We always like cheer each other on, and we always like huddle up at the end of the meets on the ramp head and do like a cheer.
We bond on bus rides to away meets.
As a tradition, the girls form a circle and do a cheer before every meet to build confidence. According to some girls, it's a way to stay together as a team with there being so many events.
Congratulations to all the runners who participated. Senior projects are a way to explore something that you're interested in and might not have the chance to do otherwise. Senior Melvis Madrigan's project went from being a grade to being a hobby and future career. Here's Nikki Teal on Madrigan's Road into the Ring.
Senior Melvis Madigan's boxing career started as a project, but turned into something much more. Madigan chose to do a senior project on boxing ethics because he thought it'd be interesting to do it on something he had never done or experienced before. Madigan has continued on with boxing and has entered in many tournaments.
At first I was a little bit disappointed because I wanted to be the state champion, but after looking back of only training for about 7 months and being second in the state, that felt great.
As a part of his project, Madigan decided to enter in the North Carolina State Golden Glove Championship. He ended up making it all the way to the final fight and placed second in the state. According to Madigan, he felt that placing second was a great accomplishment because he only trained for 7 months prior to the fight.
I honestly expected it. I told everyone he had done so well that I expected him to make it to the championship, and he did.
Madigan plans to continue in boxing competitions and enter in as many as he can. Because boxing is not as mainstream in North Carolina, Madigan travels to Tennessee, Kentucky, or places a couple of hours away for events. By the time Madigan's is out of college, he hopes to become a professional boxer. He also hopes to get attention from the USA Olympic boxing team. He believes that it'll be, with hard work and a lot of practice, accomplishing his goals will be easy.
Thanks, Nikki. Well, that's all here for sports. Back to Lindsay and Brenna to wrap up the show.
Thanks, Lily. That's all for this broadcast. Make sure to pick up a copy of the Golden Fleece tomorrow morning. Have a great Thursday. This is worldwide. Christina Aguilera.